The Philippine peso hits a fresh four-month high against the U.S. dollar. The local currency closed at 56.64 Monday as the U.S. dollar retreated against a basket of currencies. This is on expectations of dovish signals from the Federal Reserve meeting minutes and Chair Jerome Powell's speech at the Jackson Hole Symposium this week. The Philippines' balance of payments swings back to a surplus in July. Data from the Philippine Central Bank show the country posted a $62 million surplus in July, reversing its $155 million deficit in June and its $53 million deficit in the same month last year. The Banco Central cites inflows from its investments abroad and the national government's net currency deposits with the BSP. Now, this brings the Philippines' year-to-date BOP to a $1.5 billion surplus, around $700 million lower than its surplus year-on-year. Meanwhile, BSP data also shows the country's external debt servicing burden significantly eased from January to May. Total debt servicing fell 14% to $5.62 billion, thanks to a drop in principal payments. But interest payments climbed 16% to $3.21 billion. The Philippines' overall external debt now stands at $128 billion as of end March, 8.3% higher due to new borrowings from both the public and private sectors. A principal economist of S&P Global believes the U.S. is likely to cut its borrowing rates. Harumi Taguchi says America's inflation print and unemployment data makes it more likely for the Federal Reserve to lower rates in September. She adds analysts are all keeping an eye on Jerome Powell's Jackson Hole speech to see whether the Fed chair will give any clues on rate reduction. Meanwhile, Harumi notes the Philippines' growth of 6.3% for the second quarter is much better than its Southeast Asian peers. She, however, warns the private sector is contributing to slower quarter-on-quarter growth. Harumi says the central bank's recent decision to cut interest rates by 25 basis points is a sound decision for the long run.
Rate cut is probably a good call for the sustainable growth. I think it is possibly the December is the next rate cut, but as if the inflation data is more softening than we currently expected.
The Philippine Senate approves on third and final reading the proposed Blue Economy Act. That bill adopts a blue economy as a framework for the sustainable and safe use and development of marine wealth for economic growth while building resilience to climate change. It will form the Blue Economy Council, which will formulate an integrated strategy to strengthen, grow, and sustain the Philippines' blue economy. The World Bank defines blue economy as the sustainable use of ocean resources for economic growth while preserving the health of the ocean ecosystem. Goldman Sachs lowers its odds for a U.S. recession to 20%, coming from 25%. It cites recent data that were better than expected. The U.S. last week reported retail sales rose 1% in July versus estimates of a 0.3% growth, while weekly jobless claims fell to a one-month low. Goldman Sachs earlier this month raised its U.S. recession probability to 25% following a weak jobs report. J.P. Morgan followed days after, raising fears about the world's biggest economy and helping trigger a sharp stock market sell-off.